What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing Windows 11, so let's get right into it. All right, so first things first, the system requirements to get Windows 11 up and running within your machine. It looks like one of the major requirements that a lot of people have been complaining about is the Trusted Platform Module. From my understanding, Microsoft might tweak the requirements, so stay tuned for that. I am waiting for Microsoft to actually release the ISO of this particular operating system so I can import it into my SCCM server or my MDT server and push out more videos for you guys. So for this video, I'm actually going to create a new virtual machine within my VMware ESXi server. So I'm going to click on that button, create VM. I'm going to get the nice little wizard. I'm going to leave the default, click next here. I'm going to provide a name, right? Windows 11, pretty easy. Make sure you change the other settings such as the guest operating system as well as the operating system version, then click next. You're going to pick your storage, click next here. Now the next step is to customize your virtual machine. Now this is really up to you. So once you make the modifications, click on next, finish. And you're almost done. So we are going to select our new virtual machine. And from here, I'm going to click on edit. And within here, I'm going to go inside the section that says CD DVD. And then click on the drop down menu and pick data store ISO file. And I'm going to navigate to where that Windows 11 ISO file lives, right? So we are going to select it. Click on the select button. Make sure you check off connect, click on save. Once you're done saving, you're going to click on the power button right there. Just click on that power button. It's going to launch, start up. It's going to want you to press a key to boot into the CD or DVD. So just hit spacebar or whatever you want. It's going to load up the Windows operating system. Once it loads up, you're going to get this. This is really standard. This is something that we've seen so many times when installing a Windows operating system. So we are going to click next here, click on install. It's going to want you to activate it. Now for this video, I don't have a product key. So I'm going to say I don't have a product key. It's going to continue. It's going to want me to pick my operating system flavor. Now for this video, I picked Windows 11 Pro. Then click next here. Make sure you accept the license and terms. Then click next. You got two options. And the option that I'm going to pick is custom install Windows only. Then you're going to pick your hard drive. And once you pick your hard drive, click on next. It's going to start copying the Windows files. It's going to start getting itself ready. It's going to reboot. Once it's done, it's going to give you this. So this is the new Windows 11 out of the box experience, and it's pretty neat. It's sleek, and it automatically reminds me of the Mac OS environment. Yeah, the whole white and the bluish grayish tones of color. Weird, right? So you're going to pick your country. By default, it picked United States for me, so I'm going to click yes. It's going to start loading up. You're going to pick your keyboard, because once you click yes, it's going to want you to install a second keyboard. You're able to add another layout or skip it. For me, I clicked on skip. It's going to start loading again. It's going to start checking for updates, and eventually it's going to take you here. Now, this is really up to you which one you want to pick. For this example, I picked setup for work or school. Click next. It's going to want you to log into your Microsoft account. Now, one cool thing is that you are able to bypass this. And the way that you do this is click on sign in options. And then you have two options. We are going to pick domain join instead. It's going to bypass all that, you know, logging into a Microsoft account. And it's going to allow you to create a local account. So I'm going to give it a name. Once you give it a name, give it a password, make sure you confirm it, and then click next, next, next. Now, it's going to want you to add security questions. So there's three of them. Click the drop-down menu, pick a question, answer it. There's three of them. Make sure you remember them, and then click next, next, next. Once you're done, it's going to start loading up again, and eventually it's going to take you here. So once it takes you here, I kind of recommend that go over all this stuff, and most likely you want to turn all this stuff off. Once you configure it, click next. It's going to start loading again, and it's going to take you here. This might take a few minutes. Eventually, when everything is done, it's going to load up, and your start menu will pop up, which is the new Windows 11. Now, the first thing that I did once my machine was up and running, I launched my settings app and I went inside the Windows update and I checked for any updates. Now, the second thing that I did within this machine is I went inside the Windows Insider program and I just clicked on Get Started and I followed the prompts to get this machine part of the Windows Insider program so I could get the latest builds as well as the latest updates. And that's it, guys. That is Windows 11 out of the box experience, step-by-step installation process. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.